Hello and welcome to part 1 of the tutorial series How to make a Sandbox Visual Novel in Visual Novel Machinery. In this video, we'll be taking care of the setup so that we can start creating the visual novel in the following videos. This guide will focus on how to do specific things in Visual Novel Machinery, not on how to write the perfect story for Sandbox. So, let's get started. First things first, we have to get the blank template for our project. There's also the option to create the project completely from scratch, but for the purpose of this guide, we'll be using the blank template to speed up the process. So first, let's go to the website visualnovelmachinery.com and then navigate to the documentation and download the blueprint template from the getting started. Now it should open up and we can download the template. For now, I already downloaded the template, so I will skip ahead. So once we have the blank project PP zip file downloaded, we can extract it and open the folder. Now first things first, we will rename the project, because most likely you do not want your project to be named Visual Novel Blank Project.uproject. So let's rename it to Visual Novel Machinery Sandbox Project. Alright, and then let's start it up. Important thing to note here is that I'll be using Unreal Engine 5.1 for this guide. If you use any other version, that should also be alright. In general, Visual Novel Machinery will always support the latest free Unreal Engine versions, which at the recording of the video are 5.1, 5.2 and 5.3. So now let's get started and open the project. Alright, now that the project is open, let's check out the project settings and make sure everything is set up properly already for us to work in. So let's navigate down to Visual Novel Machinery UI settings and let's make sure that the simple pop-up class, the text pop-up class and the input icons are all set up so that we can work without any worries. It should be the simple pop-up widget from the plugin, the text pop-ups widget from the plugin, and also for the keyboard mouse input icons and gamepad input icons, we're using the icons that the plugin is providing as well. Then let's move on to the plugin section and check out Visual Novel Machinery plugin settings. Here we have to make sure that all of the definition tables are set up correctly. So character definitions table should point to the character definitions table, CG definitions table to the CG definitions table, and so on and so on. The in-game level name should be set to the map that we are using for the in-game level. The main menu level name should be set to the main menu map that we are using. Later on down the line, we will be using save games most likely or persistent save game. So they should be set up to the specific class that you will be using for your game. Right now it's a default class because we are not using any of it at all at the time. Also, some additional settings we have here for later down the line is if we want to generate a save file name. If we do not do that, then we will get a pop-up in-game asking us to name the save file. And also something extra is if we want to delete the save file, if we untick this, it will just directly delete the save file. If we keep it ticked, then it will ask us if you really want to do that. Then for the 3D component of the game, the camera class should be set to your camera actor. In this case, it's VNM Cine Camera Actor, but it should not be relevant for us because in this tutorial, we'll be focusing on creating a 2D visual novel sandbox. Something that can be relevant to us is the character position values. The character position values basically tell us where the character will be aligned if we move the character to the left, to the right, or to the center. So now we have here some decimal values. They have to be between 0 and 1 and basically tell you in terms of percentage of the screen. So if we say the whole width of the screen is 100% and you say the value is 0.5, as you can see here in the center, it's 0.5. It means that the character will be positioned at the center, at the lower bottom border. Last but not least, If you want to have a typewriter effect active, then you can activate it here. This will also include a setting that allows you to specify how quickly it should be typing. Also, we have an auto forward time. It's set default to 0 so that it's disabled. If you set it to something else than 0 here in the options menu, it will always automatically be enabled for users. So keep this at 0 unless you want your game to always have auto forward mode in active. Last but not least are the auto start dialog and auto start first dialog if no dialog is found. Those settings are relevant because if you disable them, then you have to manually start the dialogues in the game. Now let's move on to Visual Novel Machinery Choice Graph. Here we can just specify the dialog scene's data asset, which is relevant if you want to display a choice graph in the main menu. For now, we can ignore this, but most likely down the line we will clear the setting, because for a sandbox game the choice graph might look a little bit odd, because there will be a lot of looping. Last but not least, the Visual Novel Machinery Editor settings. This one is relevant for if you want to style all your notes. We have some default colors here set already, but you can change them if you like a different color palette. Also, one thing that's important is the dialog text note field style. This is relevant for the dialog text notes that we will use later on to specify if the whole text should be displayed in one line or if you want to have it in multi-line, meaning that the note is a little bit more compact and not completely stretched over the whole screen. If you use multi-line text for displaying the text in the dialog text node, then the auto-wrap dialog text in node add function setting is there to specify how long the text can be before it wraps into a new line. And last but not least, we also have an additional setting for a choice graph, which basically just tells the choice graph data to save itself into the dialog blueprint when we save it. If you disable this, then the saving will be a bit quicker, but also the dialog blueprints will not contain any choice data which is needed for a choice graph. Excellent. So now let's move on. Now that we have explained everything, we want to set up the final bits of the project, which includes the name of the project. Because right now it should still say blank template, and which is not what we want the game to be named. So let's rename this to VNN Sandbox Project. And the company name is me, so Alfie. It's important that you change these names, because right now the main menu widgets, unless you build them yourself, will take the values from these settings and use them in the main menu. So if you now start the game, we will now have VNN Sandbox Project written here, and I wrote it wrong. And also, if you now go to the About page, we will see created by Alfie, meaning it's taking the value we have set here in the company name. Also, we are making this with Unreal Engine 5, and we are using Visual Novel Machinery 1.7 for this tutorial. Good, now let's quickly fix the typo. And maybe also shorten it a little bit. So let's just call it Sandbox Project. Now if we start it up again, we see the title is Sandbox Project, and we didn't change anything here, so it still stays the same. Now relevant for you, because we talked about auto forward time and typewriting speed before, is that the settings you have specified, that the values that you have specified in the project settings will also be reflected here in the options menu. Meaning if you set auto forward time to something that's not zero, it will also be not zero here. If you set typewriting speed to something different in the project settings, then the initial default value will also be something different. Just keep that in mind if you are planning to change those values. All right, that will be everything for part one of the series. So now that we have everything set up, we can start the next tutorial with actually writing the first scene, which will be a configuration scene where the player is asked to configure their game to their wants and needs so that they have the perfect character that they want to play in the sandbox game. That's all from my side. Have a great evening and goodbye.